Good morning, everyone. Today is Tuesday, May the 10th. We're headed into Endicott Arm. As you can see, the weather this morning is quite foggy and windy. It's a bit chilly this morning. We should be in there in about 45 minutes or so. I just wanted to give you an update on our location, and there'll be some clips to follow. And again, thank you for following along. The captain has made a decision not to go any further in because of all the ice. They don't want to take any chances with damaging to the ship, and then not being able to turn around and in with all the icebergs and that. So he's just doing a slow turn.
Well, a very good morning once again, ladies and gentlemen, and we're enjoying the scenic beauty here in Endicott Arm. Well, we've just got to a point where we've made a decision and consultation with our local experts on our pilots here from southeast Alaska that the ice is building up, and actually an area which is just down on the starboard side of the ship now, it's all building up, and it gets to the point where it's not worth fighting our way through some of the smaller ice here just to get to a point where we can't turn around. So we stopped in a relatively open area that's a good distance off the land, so you can get some good photography, see the scenery. The ice is actually coming from the Dawes Glacier, which is just a little bit further down the field here around the corner. And it does tend to calve quite rapidly at times, as it has done in the last few days. Named in 1891 it was Henry Lawrence Dawes, a lawyer from Massachusetts, but originally it was named by John Muir for Reverend Young as the Young Glacier in 1880. But John Muir, of course, was scouting out the entire area, both of Tracy Arm and Endicott Arm. And now on the starboard side at the moment, on the left-hand side of the field, as you're looking down the field, you'll see a large piece of ice near the land. And that's just at the entrance to a small cove where a gentleman named Ford was exploring the area in his sailing vessel. He got into the small cove there and took his rowing boat out and took a little bit further up the cove and saw a nice little entrance into an open and very steep-sided area. Unfortunately, though, the current did flush him out a little bit like a cork from a champagne bottle. He had such a dreadful experience that the area is named Ford's Terrors. So that's the area just down there on the starboard side of the ship now, but on the left-hand side of the field. We're going to stay here for an hour or so in the relative calm and scenic beauty of the area. You get some good experience of the wilderness here in Endicott Arm. We'll turn the ship around a few times so everyone gets a good view, and then start heading back out into the Stevens Passage. We head to the Stevens Passage at around about midday for making our way to Ketchikan. I'll make a further broadcast then, but other than that, please just relax and enjoy the scenic beauty that is Endicott Arm.
Now sideways in the actual arm, so he's swinging it around to the port side, and I'm just taking you also over to the starboard side. Here we're coming into the upside from where the ship is turning from, and they have a concern regarding all the ice for the safety of the ship, so he's decided to make the turn around. He is going to do a couple of turns at this point before heading out, but if you look, you can see there is quite a bit of ice in here, and so enjoy, and I'll just do a little bit longer on the video. says most of the ice comes not off the Endicott Glacier, it comes off the Dawes Glacier, which is over to the left here. Apparently it's been calving quite a bit with a lot of large chunks of ice that are entering into the Endicott Arm. So here on board the Royal Princess, I'm showing you the swimming pool. I put a fountain show on here at the center, and then there's a small pool in behind, a couple of hot tubs on the upper deck. And today there's not a lot of people out here. It's a little bit chilly and rainy, and we're in Endicott Arm. And so people are watching all the icebergs, as you can have a look in the background. On the same level, we have a pool area, it's called the Sanctuary, as well with the retreat bar, and the pool with the cabanas. So on deck 16, you have the Prego Pizzeria. This is an open area. Pizza. Then over to the right, there's the Mermaid's Tail Bar. And as we continue on, you can see the Trident Grill. Trident Grill has hamburgers and, and chicken burgers and that type of thing. Pretty good. On a nice day, it's nice to come out and grab something here and eat. An area they call us, I think it's called the Skywalk. Good morning. Kind of neat because you can see through to the bottom. Moving along at sea, you can see all the waves and everything. It's pretty cool. And this is located on deck 16 as well.